Hey everybody, Robert Nicholson here at the Philos Project, here to talk about what the heck is happening in Jerusalem. This is a message, a question I'm getting from lots of people via text, via email. I want to break it down in a little bit of detail. What we have here is a conflict cocktail, a mixture of different things that came together that leads to this phenomenal violence that we're seeing on the ground. Some of the worst violence we've seen since the Philos Project has been open. The first thing we see is a long-standing 100-year-old conflict that is always simmering just below the surface. It never goes away. The spark that ignited that conflict yet again is the second factor, which is a property dispute between Jews and Arabs in an Arab neighborhood of East Jerusalem. If you want to find out more about it, go online and look into it. The third thing is that all of this happened during the end of the Ramadan holiday in the Muslim world. You have large numbers of Muslims coming from the West Bank, from Jerusalem, from Israel proper, into the Haram al-Sharif, the Temple Mount. And these people are already coming in a moment of heightened religious feeling. And those feelings have been stoked by the terrorist group Hamas. Obviously, those crowds led to clashes with the Israeli police. Not helping matters at all was the fact that all of this happened on Jerusalem Day, on Sunday, which was the day that Israelis celebrate every year the reunification of Jerusalem in the Six-Day War. Large crowds of Jews, nationalist Jews, also in Jerusalem, ending up clashing with the Arab Muslim crowds coming to the Temple Mount. In addition to that, recently the long-awaited elections for the Palestinian people were canceled after many months of preparation with very little explanation, leaving the Palestinian people even more frustrated than they were a few months ago. Add to that a bevy of very unhelpful and I would say even unconscionably violent international voices weighing in, fanning the flames, all but egging on the fighting. All you have to do is go on social media, you'll see plenty of it. People who don't know anything about this conflict weighing in with their views, most of which have to do with penalizing one side, the Jewish side, over the other. And of course, always in the international media, you have a disproportionate focus on Israel. People are not talking, unfortunately, about Sinjar or Artsakh or Ethiopia or Nigeria or Lebanon or Cyprus or Northern Iraq or all the other places that we work on at the Philos Project. A few families are threatened with eviction in this Arab neighborhood in East Jerusalem, and the whole sky comes crashing down. All of this together is what led to this round of violence, a terrible round of violence. We have compassion for people on both sides. We are praying for peace for people on both sides. But we're encouraging all of the people in the Philos Network and beyond, look a little deeper. Don't rush onto social media with a hot take. Try to find out what's actually going on before you weigh in. That is how you promote positive Christian engagement in the Middle East. Everything else flows from that.